Hello and welcome. In a previous tutorial, we got to know the basics of surface-based matching with MVTec HALCON. In this video, we'll learn how to prepare your 3D data to improve the robustness and speed of surface-based matching. Let's have a look at an example. Using this setup, we want to locate these wooden blocks. For simple objects like this, you can handcraft your 3D object model. Here, we can use GenBox Object Model 3D with the dimensions of the wooden block in meters. Let's take a look at it. Right now, it is a simple geometric primitive. Note that when creating a surface model, there are specific requirements for defining the model. First, the 3D object model that is used as the input needs to contain points. Second, it has to contain either point normals, a polygon mesh, or a 2D mapping. Currently, the generated 3D box contains no such data. Using Triangulate Object Model 3D, we can generate points and a triangular mesh for the box. When inspecting it, we can check out the primitive again, as well as the triangles and the points. One last hint. Before creating the surface model, it's a good idea to check your object model for unnecessary surfaces. For example, some CAD models have surfaces on the inside. However, those surfaces can never be observed by a camera and thus should be removed. In our case, because of the symmetry of our object, we could remove some redundant triangles of the backside of the box. Speaking of symmetry, have a look at the documentation for the operator set surface model param. To speed up the matching, you can define symmetries of your object. In our case, we can define the symmetry pose like this. Additionally, you can restrict the range of rotations in which the surface model is searched for. Before we start optimizing performance, however, we need to create the surface model. Then we can try to locate it in some 3D scenes. First, let's take a closer look at where the 3D scene is coming from. Here, the 3D sensor returned a 2D mapping, consisting of an image triple that contains the X, Y, and Z coordinates of 3D points. The data of 3D sensors often contains invalid data, where the 3D scene could not be reconstructed. Those pixels often have a gray value of 0, and thus appear black. This can lead to false results and increased runtime. We highly recommend filtering out these invalid pixels by using a threshold, for example. In this case, we already did this when acquiring the images. And one last tip. If your 3D data is noisy, you can apply a median filter on the Z image. Now, using the operator XYZ to object model 3D, we can create a 3D object model of the scene. Alternatively, the 3D scenes could also be the output of reconstruct surface stereo, using a stereo camera setup, for example. Regardless of the source of the 3D point cloud, next we use Find Surface Model to locate the surface model. For this, the 3D scene just needs to contain points and either point normals or a 2D mapping. Then we visualize the result of the matching. You might note that only one match is found. This is the default setting for Find Surface Model. Using its generic parameters, we can set Num Matches to 5. Just to provoke some more problems. Now, when visualizing the result, the three wooden blocks are found correctly. However, there are false matches in the background of the scene. The score is nearly as high as the score of the correct matches. One way to resolve this would be to use edge information contained in the 3D scene. More on this in another tutorial. Another way to avoid this problem is to remove the background from the scene. This can also speed up the matching significantly. There are different approaches available for this, both in the 2D and the 3D data. For example, if you have a planar background, you can apply a threshold to the Z image or use Select Points Object Model 3D to select only points near your camera without the background. Alternatively, you could also save the background. Then, in the Z image, you could use sub-image to filter out the background. In the 3D data, you could use Distance Object Model 3D and Select Points Object Model 3D to select only points with a certain distance from the background. Note also the operator Region Growing, which can yield fast and robust results on the Z images. It is especially useful for tilted and uneven backgrounds. If possible, we recommend using the 2D methods, since they are more efficient. Let's have a look at the Z image here. Using the gray histogram, we can threshold the image and separate the background from the foreground. Then we can insert the respective code. Next, we reduce the domain of the Z image using the resulting region. Let's have a look at the result. First, note that the runtime of Find Surface Model has been reduced quite a lot. Unfortunately, there are still false matches. Now, however, their score is significantly lower. Thus, we can go back to Find Surface Model and simply increase the min score. Finally, we can reset this program and go through all 3D scenes. The wooden blocks are now found correctly. This concludes the tutorial. Next, you can check out our tutorial on edge-supported surface-based matching. Thank you for watching.